for the compose, you can click the compose mail. After composing the mail, you are getting the compose box. For me, this looks like a very small box. Therefore, I'm going to be open the compose email in a big interface. For this, I'm going to the full screen. So once I click the full screen, you can see the full screens of my Gmail compose box. Then I'm going to paste the mail ID of my students. So all the mail ID I'm pasting here. I'm giving us a demo demo schedule 2. I'm giving the file name which is demo schedule 2. So hi all, kindly see the timetable. So I want to share the timetable to my students. Therefore, I'm going to attach one file here. Here I'm attaching one file. The PDF file I'm attaching here. Then after this, we know how to send the mail. Instead of sending, I'm going with the schedule options. For scheduling options, we can found the options near to the send. There is a small arrow mark that is called more send options. Once you click the more send options, we may find out the options called schedule send. There we can click the schedule send, and you can find out the lot of options. The default option they given us here, tomorrow's morning, this afternoon, and all. But if you want to pick the date and time, you can click the pick date and time. Suppose I like to share this mail exactly 4th today, 11:55 I want to share to all of us. So I'm giving this 11:55 or 11:51 a.m. So I'm changing this in a.m. I'm changing this in a.m. So after changing the 11:51 a.m., I'm going to give the schedule send. Once I click the schedule send, you can see these options. Send schedule 11:51 a.m. in down. Suppose you want to undo immediately, you can do the undo. So that option is also they provided. So after scheduling, you can see the option, the left side, the scheduled options. So once you click the schedule option, you can see the mail which is scheduled now. So up to 11:55, 51, the particular mail, it may locate in the schedule options. After 11:51, the mail which you compose now, it won't be available in the schedule option. Even you cannot see the schedule options after 11:51, because the schedule option after reach the particular peoples, it may goes to the send box only. This is a manner we have to send the scheduled mail. So I hope now you understand how to schedule the mail. Yes, now I am moving to the second one, how to send the confidential mail. So for what purpose we have to send the confidential mail? The purpose of confidential mail, suppose you want to share some question paper or some username and password to some specific people. That particular paper, normally what is the disadvantage we feel in the Gmail, whenever you are sharing any Gmail, automatically the receiver may forward the same mail to someone. Even they may download the printout also. Download the printout for keeping for their purpose. So sometimes that kind of mail confidentiality won't be there. That is why they make some kind of confidential based. What is the advantage of confidential? Once you send the mail to one person very confidentially, only the particular time which is fixed, that particular time only the mail is available in the particular inbox. Even the person who saw receiving the mail, they could not be forward to anyone that particular mail. Even they could not be able to download the mail also. Even they could not take a printout also. This much of confidentiality is available in the case of the confidential mail. That things I may focusing now. So the same manner you can go for the compose mail. Once you go with the compose, you are finding the compose box. So I'm going to maximize the screen of my compose box. That's why I'm going to full screen options. Now you are seeing the full screen here. Just I'm going to paste the mail ID of all yours. So here, the demonstration, I'm going to go with a confidential demo. So demo confidential, demo. I'm giving the file name as a demo confidential. How we can send the confidential mail? Suppose I'm going to send a username and password for some website. Okay, some I'll put some username, then password. I'm share as username and password, some kind of confidential based, right? this username and password, I feel that you don't need to be shared to anyone. Only this confidentiality you receive, and parallelly you can see only this only particular time only. Even if suppose I fix the confidential mail, it's available only one day. After the one day, automatically the mail may remove from your mailbox. That kind of confidentiality you are able to make it from this Gmail options. Now after compiling the mail, you can go down. Don't go send box. Instead of that, you can go to the this option. See, I hope you are seeing the options in down. Then near to the send, there is a format options, attach files. If you go the left, the right side, near to the signature, you are finding the option called turn confidential mode. Turn confidential mode. So this is options to share the confidential mail. Once you click the turn confidential mail, it asks the set expiry. Set expiry means, suppose I like to fix the mail only one day only visible to you, or 1 week only visible to you. I can fix 1 day or 1 week. So like that, I can fix the expiry date. Suppose I like to fix other things also. Okay, the timing also you can fix as you like. And one more option, suppose even the party, suppose you are sending mail. Sometimes without knowingly, the person's friends, they may open their mails. For that, we can give some more confidence like SMS passcode. Suppose if I add all your mobile number, automatically before opening my mail, you are getting the 6-digit password. Once you click, give the password only, you can see my mail. Otherwise, you cannot see my mail. Now I'm going with no SMS passcode based only. Once I go with no SMS passcode, I'm going to save. So now I fix this here 1 day. So I'm going to 1 day set expirations. Then that is for the Tuesday, January 5, 2021. I'm going to save options. Then one more options you are seeing. See here, the recipients won't have the options to forward, copy, print, or download this email. Even they could not be forward by mail, they could not be able to copy the mail, they could not be able to print the mail, they could not be able to download the mail. This much of confidentiality is there. Sometimes the party, for example, Anita, there's a chance she may share this username password to other friends. So it's not be ethical. That is why we can keep some kind of confidentiality. There is the Anita or any other student, they could not be forward the same mail to others. So for that, you can go with the confidential mode, then after that, go with the save. Once I go with the save, it automatically shows the content expired January 5, 2021. The recipients, suppose this message also you can get, recipients won't have the option to forward, copy, print, or download this email. Then edit options. You are seeing the edit option also. Apparently, I'm going to add one more mail of mine to tiago.ck@gmail.com. So here I'm adding another mail also. Then after adding all, I'm going to send. I click in the send options. Once I click send, automatically the mail it goes reached to all the students. Yeah, see here, this is a mail I'm sending. Normal mail ID, we can see the forward option. So if you click here, you can see the forward options. No forward, only the reply option. See here, you are able to see the reply only. Are you able to take a printout? Kindly try for the printout. Click this printout options. Now see here, what is showing the printout option? What is showing the printout options? Even the printout option also, it shows that you could not take a printout. Yeah, so you cannot find out the no forward options. Even you cannot find out the print option. Even you cannot be copy the mail also. You can try for copying the mail. You can try for copy this mail. Try for copy. So this mail automatically may deleted exactly January 5, 2021. Up to this, it may be visible. Up to this mail is visible to all of us. So tomorrow automatically 11:50, the mail deleted from your inbox. So you sent some confidential mail. Good. Yes. So passwords is typing. See, suddenly I am not able to copy. See, I'm trying to select, even it's not selecting also. Even I could not find the options called forward. Normally all other mails you may find the forward options, but this kind of mail you cannot say find the forward. Even you could not take a printout also. If you take the printout also, you can get this kind of options. It shows like this only. Saranya B sent you as an email of confidential. you could not download, you could not take a printout, that kind of options you may see from there. So this is your Gmail, the confidential mail features. So do you have any other doubts? Can you move to the next? Then Sufay did, Anushri did, very good. Kitis did, Musambil did. Congrats to all. So kindly use this kind of features to share some kind of confidential things. Even if you want to share some confidential things to your friends, your close friends, suppose sometimes they may misuse our content. Suppose you want to share your photos to someone, you can share like this through confidential mode. Some, we cannot believe that how they are using our photos and all. Better you can share this photo, even they could not be downloaded. They could not download your photo also. Confidential, then Arya sees in the confidential mail. Good. So always you know some kind of confidential, you should aware of it, some kind of confidential things to some kind of tools. Whenever you are sharing some official document or your personal photos also, send, even you may have some faith with the people, but sometimes knowingly or unknowingly they may share to others. So better to share the mail like this. If you are sharing your own photos or sharing some important question paper or sharing some kind of official document, personal document, you can share like this. Yes, okay, now I move to the third one. How to fix the signature? So from this I could know that some other people is not fixing the signature. What is the purpose of signature? Signatures, it's good for whenever you are sending the mail, in down itself they can find out the person's names as well as the designations. So kindly see my mail, which the mail which I'm sharing to you, all the mail you are seeing my signatures, like whom I am, I, where I'm working, I'm giving some kind of other things, what is my website address, what is my Gmail address, that kind of signature I fix. In the case of the official communication, you should highlight your name. See, the Surya's is given the Surya Narayana. Therefore, I can know who is sending this mail. But see this case, some of the people are having the different names like DP. I couldn't know who is DP and all. So once I look on, open the DP only, I can know who is sending this, because she put as an Usha Devi. Then only I can know the mail which I received from the Usha Devi. This kind of issues may come. Therefore, whenever you are sending the mail, you can send with your details the mail. Okay, so for whom the person's getting the mail, they may automatically from see their signature columns. Just I'm going to do the demonstration how to fix the signature. Please kindly see my screen. For fixing the signature, you can go with a different mode. You can go with the setting options. There you can find the signature. But I'm going to give you a very small user-friendly way to reach the signature box. For this, you can go with the compose, because we always use the compose box. Then after composing, I'm going to the big screen. So I'm opening the full screen of my compose box. There you may find out the option send, then text, there's an attached file. See, in the last option, you can see the options called insert signature. This option only I'm going to highlight. The signature is nothing but your details. See, this is my mail. You are seeing my entire descriptions, like what is my mail, what is my name, where I'm working, then what is the my research ID, what is my Scopus Author ID, what is my Orchid ID. These are my research-based IDs. So this also I'm attaching here. So like that, whenever you are sharing any mail, it should be down this kind of details. When you go for the higher education, so when you go for PhD and all, you may find out, you may know what is the society and all. Now it's not needed, just you can type your name as well as your designations and all. Okay, as well as your mail ID and mobile number. So these things you have to keep it as a signature. Now I'm doing the demonstration how to fix the signature. I'm already fixed the signature, that's why you're seeing the signature here. For your end, you are not seeing anything here. What you have to do, click the insert signature. Once you click the insert signature, you are finding the options called manage signature, my signature, no signature. Suppose I like to make new signature, therefore I'm going to manage signature. Once you click the manage signature, you are seeing the setting box. You are seeing the settings options. See here. Once you close the mail inbox, you are seeing the setting options. There automatically my signature option comes there. you can go with the edit options. Suppose you are already having the signature, you might see these edit options. Otherwise, you can type here. There is a box you may see from here. You can type with regards or with love, your name, your designations, your mail ID. Just you can type. You can just type. Otherwise, what you can do, you can copy and paste my signature and do the editing. Suppose you like to change the color and font. So for changing the color and font, it's available. Suppose you are not familiar with this, you want to change, you like my font and style, better to copy my things and do the editing in your end. Just to copy and paste the mail which I'm sharing previously. Copy and paste and do the editing there. That also option available. Otherwise, you can type your name, designations, other things in down. After typing all, you can go down. You can go down. You might see the option called save changes. Please kindly click the save changes. Suppose I like to do some modification, do save changes. Because I didn't do any modification, that's why it's not there. Okay. First, I'm putting the thank you all. Okay. So I'm giving the thank you all. Then save changes may happen. So click the save changes. Once you click save changes, automatically the changes you made in the signature, it may come here after whenever you are composing any mail. So this is why we have to fix the signature. Normally when you are sending any official things, you can keep this kind of signature. So that is some kind of official manner you have to share your mail. I'm clicking the save changes. So after save changes, you can go to the compose box. You can see, once you go with the compose, automatically you can see my signature. The same way you are finding the signature. You can type the content the above the signature. So you have to type the content, hi all. The signature demo. So I'm putting the hi all, signature demo. I'm pasting the mail ID of all your works and sending it. So I'm adding my other mail ID also and sending it. Can you check, you are seeing my content, parallel you are seeing my signature also. Like that, I request all the students, kindly create your own signature and send one empty mail to me. So very simple. Once again, I'm going to tell compose, go to the compose and go to the insert signature options. Then go with manage signature. Suppose you don't like to add the signature or my signature. You can change the no signature or my signature. Suppose if I go with no signature, my signature won't be there. If you click my signature might be there, then you can send. Suppose some people you want to share the mail without signature. What you have to do? Click the insert signature and click no signature. So nothing is there, you can compose the mail and send to them. Suppose you like to add your signature, you already composed, no? So the manage signature you already managed. Therefore, I'm clicking my signature, automatically my signature may come. Then after that, you can send to the people, those who want to share the mail. This is why we have to send the mail with the signature or without signature. I move to the other options in the Gmail. How to change the customization of the color background of your Gmail. Hopefully most of them knows. Those are not aware of it, kindly look onto my screen. For changing the background colors, you can go to the setting options. In the setting options, you are finding the options called themes. See, the setting options look like that small wheel symbol. Once you click, you find this small interface. There you are finding all the options. Okay, there the main options we are going to do is themes. I want to know the entire thing, that's why I'm going to click the view all. Once I click the view all, you can find there plenty of images. You can select the images which you want to keep as a background. That is the advantage. You can fix it. Suppose you like to add your own photos. What you have to do, even you can down, there is an option called my photos. You can upload your own photos. That also you can keep it as a background. Suppose I like to keep this photo as my background. I can select this background. So I can select this background and select it. Automatically the background, see here my background now is color. The background color. Like that you can add your own photos. Your own photos are the image which you want to keep it the backside of your Gmail. That also permissible. Suppose you are using some kind of organization mail. You can keep your organization mail logo in the backside of your email. That's good for looking. You can easily to identify what is your official mail ID, what is your personal mail ID from this color itself. So once again, do the demonstration how to change the themes. Go to the settings. In the settings, I'm going to themes. The themes, a lot of options are available. The default themes they're providing. Even you can add your own photos here. That's also permissible. There is an option called text background. You want to, then other options, even the blur screen options also they're providing. But I like to go with the green color. So that's why I'm going to select these options. I'm going to save. After selecting this, go with save. So automatically the background make colors, change colors now. Now see this visibility. So there is an option they're providing is a blur also. You can try for what is a blur also. They're adding the blur screen, blur options. Once I click the blur, it tells the what blur it means. Light blur or a dark blur. See, I'm going to do the blurring. Then save. So if I go with the blur, the image is blurring a lot. So we can change the blur at any time, the background color which you want to fix the background. Suppose I move to the other color, other image. Even you can select from down, you can add any photo. Suppose I like to add photos, I already mentioned my photos. Then you can add the photos and select. Suppose I like to go with this and select the book image. Select and select. So now see my screen. So like a book background. Like that you can customize your background setups. I hope now you know how to do your background setup. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the chat box. If you have the doubts in this. Can I move to the next level? So within 10 minutes, I may finish it. So other features I'm going to highlight in Gmail. Just I'm highlighting how to change the themes in the Gmail. Do you have any doubts? Kindly type in the chat box if you have doubts. Otherwise, type in the chat box, no. I'll move to the next level. If you don't have doubts in the sense. Okay. The next important things I'm focusing here. Some of the Google tips, Google Gmail tips. Gmail tips. So Arya, she don't have any doubts. Now I move to the tips of the Gmail. So normally when you want to forward a mail or reply a mail, normally what you are doing, suppose I like to send the reply to the Arya mail. What I'm doing normally? So what normally we are doing, once you click the mail and we are finding these options. So we are finding the reply options or forward options. All the options we are finding this one. But this thing is not needed. Instead of opening the mail, without opening also we can share the reply, we can forward the mail, all the options are available. Just I'm going to show how I'm doing the reply option. Suppose I like to send the reply to the Mozambique or forward the content shared by the Mozambique to someone. What I'm going to do, instead of opening the mail, I'm keeping the cursor, the mail which the Mozambique sent me, and right click. Once I click the right click is option, you are finding the plenty of options. See, this is for the reply option. Suppose I like to send the reply for the Mozambique. I can click the reply, automatically I can send the reply to the Mozambique. See here, the Mozambique. The first option for Mozambique, for replying, without opening the mail. Next, suppose the mail is composed by the plenty of people. Suppose I want to send the reply to all the mail people, I can go with the reply option. Suppose I like to forward the mail to someone, the Mozambique mail, I can go with the forward. Automatically the Mozambique mail comes down, I can forward to anyone without opening the Mozambique mail. Next, I am moving to the forward as attachment. Suppose I like to forward with attachment of the persons, the mail which sent someone to me. That options are available. Next, it's archive. Suppose you like to keep this mobile, the mail is an archive mode. Like keep us here, instead of dating, you can keep it in the archive mode. If you need to open later, for this we can use the archive mode. And then if you like to delete the, suppose I like to delete the mail, I can click delete and automatically it means to go. Suppose I like to go with Arya. If I go with Arya, the delete option I already mentioned. Suppose you want to fix mark as unread. This message I like to read later only. That's why I'm fixing the mark as unread. Then snooze. So what is a snooze? The particular time like a sleep mode. Snooze is nothing but a sleep mode. Suppose I like to show this mail exactly tomorrow 12 o'clock only. But the RA sent the mail now, but I like to remain the mail. The mail, it won't be visible up to tomorrow to my inbox. What I'm going to do, I can click the snooze. It has the time. If once I click the time, the particular time up to that time, the mail won't be available in my mailbox. Exactly that particular time which I fix now, that time only is visible to me. That option is called snooze. Then other option, suppose you want to fix, suppose RA is sending some kind of correction to me. I want to fix that correction work as a task to me. It automatically go to the task. There is a Google Task app. It may directly link with the Google Task. So like we can fix some kind of day-to-day task. That day-to-day task, we can finish it. Once you finish it, we can mark it here. That is the option. That is the separate application called Google Task. That option is also available. That option is also available. Then other right click. Once I go with other right click, you are finding the move to. I hope you know what is the move to. Suppose the mail which you create, which you receive from someone, some kind of important thing. You want to keep this mail in some folder. See, I'm keeping this much of folder, like CU Kerala, CUTN, Google One, Guest, IGNO, Journal. Like that, I'm creating lot of folders. So this folder based, I'm sharing this mail. For example, I like to send this mail of Arya to the Central University of Kerala. So what I'm going to do, move to Central University of Kerala, automatically the mail to moves to the Central University of Kerala folder. Like that, we can keep the mail at any folder. And suppose you want to keep the mail in some kind of label, you can create your own label, like a folder name. If you want to mute your the particular mail, you can go with mute. So this much of tips, small user-friendly tips is available in the right-click itself. You don't need to be open the mail. Without opening the mail, right-click the mail and you can find out this much of options. So this much of options is good for to reduce your time while using the Gmail. I hope this features may be good for you. This much of features, as part of our teaching and learning purpose, you can use it. Why I'm using some kind of tips also, sometimes for opening the mail, it takes much delay. So instead of opening the mail, right click and do everything. In this manner, we can reduce the time and we can finish the task as early. So for the purpose, we need some kind of tips also. Hopefully, you may understand some of the good tips now, that the things which I'm discussing here today, how to schedule the mail, how to send the confidential mail, how to insert the signature, then finally I may highlighting the some of the tips in the right click based tips that also I highlighted. Hopefully it's good for you. Thank you all.